Wake Forest is getting fired up down there as they get ready to boot this opening kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Tigers have got a guy at quarterback that is a true leader. We found that out this week talking to him.
We sure did, Brad. It was interesting this week, and as you and I prepared for this game, finding out that he called a players-only meeting without any of the coaches just to get this team focused and let them understand what it takes to go on the road and to win this kind of game. And when you have that kind of leadership, you got a real chance to be able to go on the road and win. How did he drop that? The defender did everything that he needs to do. He read the play perfectly. He stepped up, and what does he do? He drops the interception. Boy, the offense caught a break there.
Zips it to the tight end. Tackle at the 42.
If you're going to put the ball into that kind of coverage, you better be accurate, or you'll be wearing a baseball cap and headphones on the sideline standing next to the coach.
Yellow 7.
Tackle made right around midfield. They run the option, and it's the tailback who gives them an 8-yard gain on the play.
That makes it second and two.
Got a man, but he's tackled back behind the line of scrimmage.
They were on him almost as soon as he took the handoff.
They're stacking the line. It looks like they're coming after this punt. And this one is a beauty. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. The ball changes hands on the punt. Nice opening stand by the defense.
I'm sure the fans are thrilled to see their guys come up with an early stop in this game. Let's see if the offense can give them something else to get excited about now.
Play action here. He's going to scramble. The ball is loose. Recovered by the offense. And he's taken down right around the 30. Wow, very close to turning it over, but they'll keep possession of the football.
Way to play heads up out there. That's just one more reason to play to the whistle.
From their own 30-yard line, it's second down. He's tackled at about the 41. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
Well, this comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver, and the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
And he's tackled right around the 42-yard line. Down he goes at the 39. And the linebacker comes up and makes a big stop.
This is textbook. This is how you're supposed to play against the run.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 49. He airs it out. Oh, he had a shot at the pick. And that one probably should have been picked off.
Yeah, are you kidding me? There's a blanket around that receiver. Somebody else had to be open.
He gets it away. And this is a really nice punt. He's tackled at the 25-yard line. They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing. And they make the stop at the 21.
That's got to be very frustrating for that running back. This offense is trying to get in sync and trying to get a rhythm established. And for such a negative play to happen, loss of yards, it can really have a negative impact on the offense and what they're trying to do.
From their own 21-yard line, second down. He's on the run, and he can't get away from the pressure.
That'll bring up third and one.
Well, the defense stood tall there.
Well, the defense did what they had to do to get three and out and now get the offense back on the field.
That makes it fourth and long.
They've got 10 guys up. They're coming after the kick. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. He's taken down at the 47-yard line. This is a fun game, and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over. Runs it and tackled in the backfield.
Loss of two on the play. That'll bring up second and 12.
It's second and 12. Ball on the 45.
Well, we talked all week with these coaches, and even when we met with them yesterday out at practice, they told us there's some big concerns about facing these defensive ends. They thought that they might be able to hold up against him, maybe get the ball out of the pocket a little bit quicker, maybe use running backs and tight ends to help with double teams on the outside. But right now, whatever they thought they might be able to do, they better get back to that drawing board because these defensive ends are just too quick.
Booming kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Boy, this has really been stingy by both of these defenses. The question is, can they keep this pace up, though?
I think that's a big challenge for them to be able to continue to play like this. Right now, the emotion of the game is favoring the two defenses, but I get a feeling it's a matter of time until one of these offenses starts clicking.
And a quick throw. And he's finally knocked out of bounds at the 45-yard line.
That's a deep three.
And now he's got room to run. Brought down at the 44.
Call it a gain of 11 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Hey, alert 48. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield.
No gain.
I hope you brought your lunch because I'm about to take
it. Okay. He gets rid of this one.
Great job by the defense of getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 34.
Well, you hate to foreshadow and assume that that drop could come back to bite them, but if this offense is able to put the ball into the end zone after that drop pass, this game could be over.
He's going to try to coffin corner this one. He really got a hold of that one. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. Bring him down around the 17-yard line.
Well, give the defense all the credit here. They had that one snuffed out from the start. It could have been an even bigger loss.
It's second and 13. Ball on the 17. Nice run, and he's brought down. We've played one. No score here. We can only hope the second quarter is as good as the first. Tight ball game, folks. Here they come. He's taken off. He's taken down at the 40.
the 49. Just another weapon for this offense. He's got good hands, and he's tough to bring down. He showed right there that he can make something big happen.
And he hits him hard at the 49-yard line.
Well, the defensive line got such a good push up front that there was no one on the offense to account for the linebacker. And he got through almost untouched.
From their own 49-yard line, second down.
The defense was just all over that play. It didn't fool anybody. You have to keep an eye on this guy, especially during passing situations, because he does a great job of getting to the quarterback, as we saw right there.
Fourth and long here after the sack. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. Well covered by the kicking team. He didn't go anywhere.
What I like about this play is that the guys stayed in their lanes and didn't allow the big play.
They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now.
And he throws it away. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 28-yard line. Maybe 6 yards there on the scramble. Tackle made at about the 39-yard line.
Well, on third down, we expected them to go to the air, and they did just that, picking up the first down.
Give to the running back, and he's going to lose yardage. Second down, 13 yards to go. Ball on their own 36. Makes it out to about the 50. Level at the 35-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
He's got an opening. Makes it to the 27.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't want none of this.
That makes it second and 2.
Makes it out to about the 13.
That's a gain of 14 yards on the play. First down.
Here he goes. Touchdown, Clemson.
Outstanding run and great execution by the entire offensive unit, especially the blocking up front.
works the extra point. An 11-play, 83-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. It can really demoralize a defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. He gets hit out of bounds around the 27-yard line. That makes it second and eight. Flips it middle to the running back. And he tackles him hard at the 28-yard line. The man defense proves to be too tough against the screen.
That was an excellent job by the defenders. They fought off their blocks and found the ball before the play had a chance to develop.
Yellow three.
He scrambled. He gets sacked on the play.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
It's away, and it's a booming punt. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. Clemson's offense is just clicking on all cylinders, Herbie, right now. It's everything they planned for, and it's all working.
Everything is coming together for this offense. They seem to be getting better with each series. And, you know, this game started where this team was, you know, they wondered if they were going to be able to move the ball against this defense. And I think right now, I think they seem to, as I said earlier, they seem to be growing with their confidence with each possession.
Quick throw, and he is drilled at the 43-yard line. Clemson is up by a touchdown. Throws it in a hurry, and he's taken down around the 47-yard line.
Call it a gain of 4 yards. That makes it second and six.
Fires quickly, and he's got his man, and he's tackled right away.
Number 15 on the tackle at the 45-yard line.
They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. He might have a chance, and they finally push him out at the 9-yard line.
Call it a gain of 36 yards. That makes it first and goal.
Hoping to double their lead here as they close in on the goal line. Gets to about the 8-yard line.
That brings in second and goal.
Looks to a receiver, touchdown! And did that play ever develop nicely?
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
It was a textbook post route, and the pass was right on target. And he adds the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Their last drive resulted in a punt, so let's see if they can put together something a little more promising here. Gets it off as he's hit, complete. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 38-yard line. From their own 38-yard line. First down. And he's going to come up with a sack. Wake Forest is going to have to use their second time out of the half.
Green nine. Orange.
Kill.
Yellow.
slings it. He's tackled at the 41-yard line. Steps up, and they bring him down for a sack on the play.
Man, it's an offensive lineman. This is the worst thing that you want to see, is your quarterback not only getting sacked, but getting hit like that. Those linemen better pick that quarterback up and start doing a better job of taking care of him.
And this one is a beauty. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. The Tigers are sitting pretty now after getting off of that slow start at the beginning.
Yeah, things were a little sluggish early, but my gosh, these last few series, they just seem to be, at this point, just kind of setting a tone and kind of having their way against this defense.
The offense now will take the field, and they hope to have the same success they had on their last drive.
So much of the passing game is about timing between the quarterback and his wide receivers. Right now with this offense, they are in sync, and really the timing and execution is flawless.
In the shotgun and five wideouts. Quick strike, and he drops it. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. And we'll probably see how far he can throw it, as it should be the last play before the half. That's a great tackle at the 24. It's been a well-fought game as we head to the half. 14-0, Tigers.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Rhys Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. There is nothing, and I mean nothing, that is more important than turnover. Now, so far, neither defense has been able to force one in this game, but you never know when that opportunity is going to come up.
No, and people look at turnovers and they assume that it's luck a lot of times, but a lot of times it's preparation. It's being able to know that when certain teams line up, like South Carolina back in 2002, in a certain formation where it's Tucson open stud, and they got three receivers to my side, and I know it's a rollout pass. As a defensive end, I widened my stance a little bit, came upfield, hit the quarterback as he was throwing it. Next thing you know, the ref signals his hands up in the air, and you get 6 points for it. So you can definitely be prepared, and that's how you force those turnovers.
Just about time to start the second half. What do you think Herbstreit's first point of analysis will be?
I don't know, something to do with quarterback play, I'm sure. I mean, always got to hear that stuff all the time. It's all about the quarterbacks.
Brad and Kirk ready for the second half.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Tigers continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. And down he goes, right around the 26-yard line.
The defense got a great push and blew that play up well behind the line of scrimmage.
That'll make it third and 13.
From their own 22-yard line, it's third down. He wants it all, going long. No, incomplete. And that'll make it fourth down.
Great hold by the defense. They were expecting the pass play, and they defended it very well.
He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. They were lucky to prevent a big return there.
Yep, that could have been big if he could have gotten a few more blocks and was able to find the seam.
They're ready to begin another drive. He's scrambling. And he's tackled right around the 42-yard line.
Gain of 5 yards. That brings him second and 5.
41's coming. 41's the mic. Sit down.
Now he's scrambling. Room around the corner. And they make the stop at around the 44-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 14 yards. First down.
There's a strike complete. He's hit and taken down.
Number nine brings him down on the 41-yard line.
Three down.
That makes it second and six.
Under heavy pressure, he sails it long. Brought down at about the 9-yard line.
A lot of the credit for this big play has to go to the offensive line for keeping the pressure off so that the quarterback could find his open man.
And he's hit immediately. Maybe got 2 feet on the play.
Well, it's a good job here to just secure the football, but he just doesn't have enough speed to turn that into something big.
They'll get him in the backfield.
You keep gaining negative yards, and you put yourself in a position of having to make bigger and bigger plays. Puts a lot of pressure on that quarterback.
Well, it's third and goal, and they're 10 yards out. Zips it to his receiver. Touchdown. He makes the PAT. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Clemson's coaches just got to be happy. I'd love to coach a kid like this.
Oh, I think these coaches love to coach a guy like this. And another great performance by him individually and for this offense.
The defense did a nice job shutting down the offense the last time they had the ball.
If they're going to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling. Where the defense has to be very frustrated there. They did everything. They got to the quarterback. In fact, it looked like they had a chance to bring him down for the sack. And somehow, he's able to throw the ball away.
From their own 25-yard line, second down. Throws to the tight end, and that falls incomplete.
Number 80, the intended receiver on the play. That brings us third and 10.
Four down. Close the mic. Here we go. Go!
Well, the defense stood tall there.
Well, the defense did what they had to do to get three and out and now get the offense back on the field.
That'll make it fourth and 10.
Booming kick. And he's tackled at the 36. The offense will be hoping they can move the ball as well as they did on their last drive.
This offensive coordinator's got to be feeling so good about the execution that he's seeing from his quarterback and his wide receiver. Because, again, they put so much time in trying to put a plan together. And to be able to see that actually come into play makes you feel pretty good as a play caller.
From their own 31-yard line, second down. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
Gain of 6 on the play. Third down.
Completes it, but he can't shake the defense.
Game seven. That'll bring up fourth and one.
He really got a hold of that one. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. For Clemson, they've been coming after the quarterback all day long. This is turning into a day that the offensive line wants to forget. the good plays from this defense has helped them into the lead. The offense is looking to be a little bit more successful with this drive as they had to punt the ball away the last time they had it.
Down two possessions, this offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
He's out to the 30. Tackle around the 34-yard line. They'll bring him down at about the 47-yard line. Taken down at the 13-yard line.
You know, the wide receiver here does a good job of running a nice route, but I think it's the concentration, what he did at the end of the route, that made the difference. He felt the coverage. He knew that he had a man on him, but he's able to keep the defender away from the football and go up and make a nice catch.
First and 10, ball on the 13-yard line. Run there as they work the outside.
That makes it second and six.
Mike 12. Black five.
They're not done yet.
He kept it himself and created the whole thing with his feet. Boy, was that fun to watch or what?
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Let's see if this drive has a more rewarding conclusion than their last, which ended with a punt. Complete. He's got room.
That'll make it second and seven.
He fights forward to about the 30. Well, this turned out to be a pretty good ball game, and we've got one quarter to go. The Tigers lead it by two touchdowns. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter. Get to that quickly. And he's tackled in the open field.
Perfect timing here between the quarterback and the wide receiver. That's a big gain and more than enough for the first down.
Nice catch, first down, and he's knocked out.
He looked pretty cool back there. Even with the outside linebacker blitzing, he made an accurate throw, and the result is a new set of downs.
Quick throw, incomplete, wanted his receiver.
Number 19 was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second.
From the 49-yard line, it's second down.
Get that quarterback!
Gains his way to the 36-yard line. He makes his way to about the 22.
Gain of 14. That makes it first and 10.
Quick throw, and he's got his receiver again. He's tackled at the 14-yard line.
Number 41 brings him down at the 14-yard line. That makes it second and 2.
Makes it out to maybe the 13-yard line.
That's a deep one. That'll make it 31.
And he carries the ball for a nice game.
Makes the tackle. That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That makes it first and goal.
They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. They're at the 7. Second down.
Here we go. Let's bring it.
They'll go ground. And he's level at the 5.
That's a gain of 2 on the play. That makes us 3rd and goal.
Quick out to his receiver. And down he goes, just outside the goal line.
That's good for a game.
Fourth down. This one should be makeable. Kicks away, and it splits the uprights. Clemson is lining up to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. So they're just about set to get the game going again. Just under 3 to go in regulation. Here's an opening. Keeps his eye on it, makes the catch.
That's a gain of 4 on that play. That makes it 2nd and 6.
Three down. Watch two.
Check back 12.
Black, five, yellow, three.
Red, seven, yellow.
And he's immediately tackled. Fires out to his receiver. Going deep, lays it out there, and it's going the other way. It's the senior corner. Great play there by the corner to come up with a big interception.
That's not a very good pass right there. He should probably have tried to throw that one away. He was under heavy pressure and then threw it right to the corner.
From their own 9-yard line, first down. Give up the middle, tackled right away. third down. And as they come up to the line, they're going to be in the shadow of their own goalpost. Tackled at the 22-yard line.
That's a gain of 18 on the play. First down.
From their own 22-yard line. First down. Room there as they try to work the left side.
That makes it second and 10.
The Tigers know that they have to enjoy this guy while they've got him, because somewhere down the line he's going to be at the next level.
Well, that'll definitely be in his future, but for now he needs to sit back and just enjoy this performance. And really, the play caller, the quarterback, the offensive line, the receivers, the entire group as just a whole should feel good about their performance.
That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.